This is for Nimrod on Facebook. I figured I'll show you this before I even show you how the games work. I haven't even tried Daytona 2001 yet, so we'll see how it works. But you're going to have to do this to set up the controller. You have to come to the Retropie. And Retropie setup. And you're going to need a keyboard. I'm setting this up on a PS2 controller. Go to Configuration, Tools, Riecast. Enter. And it'll say put in the device ID. The ID is right up here. I got mine in a hub, so it's ID2. I believe on Easy Hacks videos, ID3. So it just depends on where it's plugged in. If you got it plugged into a hub and whatnot, and you want to map an emulator exit button? Yes. Y, enter. Press select. You want to map an A button? Yes. Enter. On this particular controller, I believe A is circle. This is the Retro Power PS2 controller. You can find it on Amazon. See, A, circle. You want to map B? Yes. B is X. You want to map C? No. D, no. X, yes. X is triangle. Want to map Y? Yes. Y is square. Z, no. Start button, yes. Start is start. You want to map D-pad 1? Yes. Left, up. You want to map D-pad 2? No. Want to map left trigger? Yes. With this controller, it doesn't matter which of the L buttons you map it to because it doesn't have a pressure-sensitive one. So I just do it with L2 and R2. L2, map right trigger? Yes. R2. Want to map the analog stick? Yes. Then do this to the left analog stick. When you're done, you want to hit cancel, or it's going to make you do it all over again. I don't know if you have to restart the system for it to register, but I'm going to just in case. Thank you. Cat's going nuts right now. Alright. Oops. Oh yeah, I got A and B mixed around.
Thank you. to me last. Alright, that was Daytona, USA. You can see it plays smooth. Just to see. Just to see. Yeah, I know. Don't worry.
Judge your brand.